One thing, I wanted to make a few comments about Greg when he was a little boy, many years ago. Usually when Betsy wanted to go away on a trip with Buzz, she would ask my husband and me to come stay with Buzz. And one time, when we went to stay with them when they were living in Tucker, Georgia, I went to look for Greg and David and some company they had out on the shady side of the house. And when I got there, I found that the three children on my side were hurling insults at a little boy that lived the backs of the houses came close together. And they were hurling insults to that little boy, and he was hurling insults back to them. And you can imagine what little 2 and 3 and 4 year old kids might be saying to each other. I was 6 years old, I think, in first grade, before he ever admitted that I was his grandmother. He was always very fond of his other grandmother. One time I was visiting at their house when he must have been about 4 years old, and he came into the room and sat down, crawled up in his granny's lap, and looked over at me and said, "Meemaw's carrot cake's a whole lot better than yours." So guess what? I never did make him another carrot cake. We had a month-long going Monopoly game, and I don't know who won or who lost, but the game lasted as long as we were there. So I think now as the years have come and gone, he may be as proud of me as he was of his grandma hymns. And I have always written little poems for the children, one that calls and another. And but I never did write one for a wedding. So when I found out that this wedding was going to happen, I wrote this little poem, if I can see the reading. There once was a handsome young man named Gregio who fell in love with the beautiful, winsome face of Miss Lydia, Genia. He said, "Since I'm a man, I must do the best I can to make her my everlasting girlie." Miss Jenny liked the looks of Mr. Gregio. see, thought of many ways to make it happier. He said, for my part, I will bind him to my heart, so he'll never, never want to leave us. So their courtship went this way and that way up. That's till they knew what they wanted to do. So that's why we're here, to bring them good cheer on tomorrow's great glorious wedding night.